Okay, now let's take a look at one way that serial print is used real quick. Now, you'll see I've got my general push button circuit all wired up just the way it ought to be. Now, I'm going to send my button sketch to the board. All right. My button sketch is done uploading. So, let's take a look at how it works. My button doesn't do anything. Hello? Hello? My light's not turning on. I don't understand this. That's just weird. All right, let's take a look. Look at our code. Look at our code looks right. So, this is where that serial print bit becomes important. And that's for debugging. So if I put in my serial begin here, got to put our serial begin in the setup or it won't work. Then what I can do is down here in the void loop, I can do a serial print. And so I can try and figure out where the program is messing up. So, what I've just put in here is I've started my serial begin, and then in my void loop, if the button's pushed, we will get a serial print. So, now I've got a different way to check whether it's the button being pressed or whether there's something else is going on that's wrong with my program or with my circuitry. So, now I'll send it. All right. It has been uploaded. Great. So I push the button and still nothing happens. But now, if I do serial monitor, now when I press the button, oh, the button was pressed. And see how it's all lining up on one line? Probably should have done serial print LN, right? Let's fix that real quick. But you can see, so if I go back and we do serial print LN and then send it. Now when I do my serial monitor, of course you can see, even though I press it, try and get just one, I get several. Because it actually does several times through the loop, even just no matter how quick I press it. But you can see it only adds new ones when I'm actually pushing the button. So I can then see from that it wasn't a problem with the programming. The programming is all correct as far as the push button goes. So why isn't the light turning on? Now that we know that piece, now that we know that the push button part of the code is working, we can look and say, okay, LED pin 13, pin mode output, great. Digital write, LED pin high, digital, just like it should be. Well, let's take a look at our circuit.
Our LED is plugged in. It goes into negative and, oh wait, there it is.
It's plugged into pin 12, not into pin 13. So there you go, able to quickly troubleshoot because we used our serial print.